Hey guys, welcome to this video on embedded C programming. Today we are specifically gonna talk about the IDEs that people uses for the embedded C programming.
So for more such videos, do subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so that you will never miss the video, and do follow us on Instagram for more updates. This series is the embedded C programming series, and this is the first introduction part. You may find this video lengthy, but in this video you will get enough information which you will never find anywhere. So stay tuned till the end.
Today's main topic is about the IDE. So through IDEs, people understand it like the environment where people usually write codes. It can be any kind of code like C programming, C++, Python, Java, and other kinds of coding languages you can use, right? So today we are going to specifically talk about the embedded C programming IDEs. So let us talk about the STM32 IDE that people are using these days a little much. So because such kind of microcontrollers are also a bit popular in the embedded community. So first of all, let us see that what kinds of microcontrollers this company provide. You people might be familiar with this kind of board, the blue pill board of ST Microelectronics. This is a kind of famous board in the developers who just start their embedded journey, right? So let us see the website. So when we click the first link of the STM32, it will take us to this website, the official website of ST Microelectronics. Let us check what kind of features or what kind of things we can get over here. STM32 family is a 32-bit microcontroller based on ARM Cortex-M processor. This generally uses M processors from M0 to M7. So let us see that what other things are being provided on this website. You can see the ARM Cortex 32-bit microcontrollers, high performance, mainstream, ultra low power, wireless microcontrollers. There are different kinds of microcontrollers that are been given over here. So people generally use microcontrollers according to their need, like what kind of needs or the what kind of main features of their product will be, like what will be the USP, unique selling point of the product. Maybe developing the ultra low power, your product may be using less power, so, or the high performance or the wireless, like such kind of things are being provided, right? So people generally use this from this stream only. Let me tell you the main product. Like I have searched the STM32 F4 over here. So let us search again. F4 or the F5 or the F3 microcontroller series are pretty much popular. So let us see the F4 series over here. So here are the F4 series. Like there are many of the different kinds of peripherals that you can get with the different kinds of F4 series microcontrollers. Like you get the LCD TFT controller and MPADSI interface over here. So there are different like serial audio interfaces is there in such kind of microcontrollers. Like if you search say this on the Google, you will get the microcontrollers that is based on such kind of like this number of the microcontroller, right? There are different peripherals in different microcontrollers. So it totally depends on what people want to use or what people want to have in their product. So let us talk about the IDE of Cube MX IDE of STM32. So here is the website of STM32 Cube IDE. If you search on Google like STM32 Cube IDE, you'll get the first link, and you just click on that, you will come to this page. So let us see what is there in this. So here you can download the data brief of this IDE, like what kind of things that they are going to provide in the IDE. Mainly, I must tell you that this IDE is basically Eclipse-based IDE. Maybe some people might be familiar with Eclipse-based IDE. This IDE, the STM32 Cube IDE, is basically on the Eclipse. So you just click here on the Get Software, and you will come to this block, or you just roll down, and you will automatically get to this block. So you just have to download it for Windows and just click on Get Software, and you will get the software for Windows. So here you have to enter your first name, last name and the email address here and download it from here. Okay, so I have already downloaded the IDE. Let us see how this IDE looks like. So hope you are seeing it right. If you want to create a new project, go to file, go to C++ project and C manage build, next. Okay, so for this, I have downloaded the GCC compiler. So I'll make a different video for this MinGW GCC compiler, cross compiler for this Cube IDE. So I'll make a different video on that. so that people can get to know that how this IDE gets linked with the main GW GCC compiler. So I'll just enter the project name like DD or something else. So click on the main GW GCC and finish. Or it maybe depends on you that what kind of compilers you want in your system. As you can see that there were two options more. So you can also use that also. Right? So after this, let me add the main, the source file, main file, like the main.c file, main.c file. So it's created and here is the main.c file. So let us check that what is there. There's nothing like content. Let us see a project like Hello World project on this IDE. So generally what people do is write in hash include stdio.h and then we go to int main and then just simply print hello world. Sorry, I have to give this space and terminate it. And yeah, so this is what we generally write for the hello world code. Like there is a library of stdio.h through which we use this function of printf, right? So this is generally a library for this function to use, right? If we don't provide the library over here, it will surely be giving us the error, right? So let us see that if this project build successfully or not. So let us build it. You can see over here if there will be any error or warning, it will be displaying over here. So there is no error and no warning. So that means that our project is pretty fine. So let us run this project. Sorry, run as local. Okay, so this there we have got the hello world. So this was just a simple project or a simple code for the hello world, right? So there's a lot of project or lot of coding that goes on from here. So as you people also know that that when we just code or when we just get this main.c file and we compile it, at the end there are many of the other file that also get generated, like you can see that main.o file or the at the .exe file, right? So you people get this files also. Let me show you the exe file, right? Let me show you the exe file where it is getting stored. Like here we have the exe file, right? So actually this is not staying. The main reason for that is actually this code doesn't have any get char over here, right? So if we type get char over here, or then also it will not be getting, like we have to store it in while loop only. Let me show you. We have to type get, sorry, we have to type get char, get char, let us give a not here, not equal to slash n, hang it into the loop, right? And then at the end we have to type get char, right? So let us see if this works or not. Oh sorry, we don't have to terminate it. Okay, so now it's clear. Let us build this project again. Okay, so there's no error and no warning. Let us check the .exe file. So we have got the, yeah, we have got the exe file and we can see that hello world is over here also. Okay, so like on our CMD, right? So this is the way like through which we can check the output on our CMD or the .exe file. And there are also other files that are created, like main.o. You can see that main.o is over here. These files are generally created by the compilers during the compilation process, right? That's it for the Beret C compiler. So there are other compilers also, like Microvision 5, or like Eclipse Environment, Microsoft VS Code. So you can use any kind of environment you want. That totally depends on you. You just have to get the compiler for your IDE, okay? So I'll make another video for the compiler also. So that's it for today.
So I hope you find this video useful and informative. So for more such videos, do subscribe our channel and press the bell icon. And do share this video with your friends who want to learn embedded. This series will be in continuation. So stay tuned and we will be back with another video. Take care and bye-bye.